Chip Ganassi. I'm at the Ford exhibit here at Las Vegas at the SEMA show. We just announced my engine supplier for 2014 and beyond. It's going to be Ford Motor Company in the Tudor Sports Car Series. We've won the 24 Hours of Daytona five or six times, and we've won the championship, I think, seven times. And, you know, we like the series. I like sports cars. I like the type of racing, and I like the competition and the competitors. I don't know if we've done all there is to do. I mean, people have said, you know, we've won a lot, and we have. I think there's always challenges. I mean, you know, we're looking at 2014 with the series coming back together, and you know, we're all the sports cars in the country are going to be under one roof. I think that's pretty exciting. I think you know, Tudor coming on as a series sponsor is exciting, and you know, just the fact that it's under the NASCAR umbrella, the sports car series has some strong backing, and I think it's got a bright future. I'll tell you what, that'd be a dream come true if we were able to go over there with our cars that we race here in the United States. I think that'd be pretty big. I think we'd pick up a lot of fans over there. I think the fans can see these are real exciting cars. They've got exciting technology. You see right here to my left, and you know, you're going to see that that this type of racing is about, you know, you can have performance and you can have economy, and that's what the EcoBoost is all about with this new Ford product. I mean, it's, you know, for many years I've been an advocate of marrying those two words, economy and performance, because for so long we've been talking about mileage and renewability and you know, economy and being green, and that's what this EcoBoost engine is all about, really. It's bringing that economy, but yes, you can still have performance with that. That's what racing's all about. It's unquestionably their strategy. I mean, you want to go as far as you can on the least amount of fuel, and that's what racing's all about. Most people don't get, that doesn't come across to the average fan, but you want to use as little fuel as possible, and that's what EcoBoost is all about. What it is it's a production block, it's production heads, a lot of production pieces in there. The biggest pieces, the crank, the block, the heads, all production based. So I think that's pretty exciting. It's what people drive on the street every day, is on the racetrack as well, performing in a racing capacity. First time you'll see this car race, 24 Hours of Daytona, ladies and gentlemen. February, late January, 2014.
Hi, Scott Pruitt here, and we're at the SEMA show, and let me introduce you to my office. Right there, that's what I do. 200 plus miles an hour. Next stop, Daytona for the Rolex 24, and couldn't be more excited. We're going there with EcoBoost, with Ford. Big announcement today. Proud to be a part. Ganassi, actually, he slipped away. Chip Ganassi, my team owner, we've been together for 10 years. We won a championship seven of those 10 years, and we don't win, we finish second. Excited to be a part of Ford. For me, a lot of years that I've been involved with sports cars. I started with Ford, Indy cars with Ford, NASCAR with Ford, over the recent years with other manufacturers, and now back to Ford. So it's been a great run. So excited to be back involved with this program. I've won the Rolex 24 overall five times, a record, I don't know, 13 or 14 times in class. So we're going back to get the overall record again. We've had a lot of success there. And the other part of this is we're going with Ford Motor Company, the engine builder, Roush Yates, second to none. They've had a year of development on the EcoBoost engine, V6, twin turbo. It's going to be great economy and performance. You got to balance those. If we can get a little bit of fuel mileage with a direct injection, which we fully expect to, we can cut down one of our pit stops, which could be the difference between winning and losing. So in years gone by, now realizing my first Rolex 24 was 1984. I know I'm dating myself. However, things have changed a lot over the years. In the last 5 years, we're going there, and it's a flat out 24-hour sprint race. The only thing you have to be concerned of is getting tied up with cars on track, either something that you get caught up with a guy or somebody that runs into you. Short of that, I mean, you run these cars hard, you run them to the limit every lap of that 24 hours. So going there, you gotta know what to do and how to do it. Back in 84, 85, 86, you'd go there, be careful of the transmission, be careful of the engine, be careful of the brakes, so on, so on, so on. Those days, a thing of the past. It's flat out, hardcore, 24 hours of sprint racing. When you look at the available technologies today, and we say the AVL Dyno, what that means is you can download data from the race car. The exact lap that we would make at Daytona, they can emulate on a dyno, and they do that 24, 25 hours. So we have a very good understanding of the durabilities needed in the engine, all the componentry. They've been doing that for the last year, both within Ford Motor Company and within Yates, Roush Yates Racing. So we're absolutely 100% confident. We're gonna, you know, come out of the box, we're gonna run strong. The biggest question mark, the rules package. The two different governing bodies coming together, Daytona prototype, as well as ALMS, and how those rules come together is kind of the bigger question right now than the actual racing that thing right there. There's always talk of Ford going back to Le Mans and doing what they did in the late 60s. It was historic, and I would be proud to be a part of that. Right now, our focus, the Rolex 24 Hour. At the end of January, go see if we can put that 01 tail cell Ford in victory lane.
Can I get an autograph? Mm-hmm.